So the most complete player in the game, 2 days short of the record, for the most time spent at world number one. He spent 34 months consecutively at world number one. It is the dragon, the captain, the dictator, Ma Long. So much respect. The ticket sales here, just to see him play in his career is a gift. It's an opportunity not to be missed. He's fought back through serious injury to be prepared for this event and has looked more prepared than I have seen in maybe his career. But the surprise visitor, the man who has made this the newsworthy match, the Swede who has been in the lead, he has been undefeated. It is world rank number 16, Mattias Falk of Sweden. What a proud moment right now. What a proud time in history for the Falk Carlson families. Formerly Mattias Carlson, married to honor his wife and the passing of her mother. Julia is his wife. He took her last name. Wow, Don. So as you get into the coin toss here, we'll determine who serves and where the players stand. You know, we've got the coaches in the corners. Jorgen Persson over here for the tall Swede. The David and Goliath. Jorgen Persson having a rich history of beating the Chinese from the late 80s through the mid 90s with Jan-Ove Waldner and Peter Carlson. And I'd like to take this moment because Peter Carlson, as a friend and a coach of the Qatar team, we've had a very dear loss on the world stage for all Qataris, for everyone around the world, the table tennis community, to honor the life of Abdal Rahman Al-Najjar. Gone too soon, life is very precious, so our hearts, our condolences go out to friends, family of Abdal Rahman Al-Najjar. So a very emotional match on the line here as well to follow. You saw the road. Here's Qin Zhijie and the personal coach for Ma Long in the corner. And who else would be here in this moment than someone who's like a father to Ma Long right now, Don?
Interesting, we've got a father-like figure in the corner of Ma Long, and then in the corner, Sweden, you mentioned Jorgen Persson there. And of course, he's a former world champion, won this title back in 1991, beat Jan-Ove Waldner in the final in Sheba. So contrasting backgrounds to the two coaches. And that's very interesting in itself, who you have sat in the corner. The important thing is here, the relationship in both corners works really well. And you can see that in between the games, the way they communicate, the way they connect. It's absolutely outstanding. Mattias Falk yesterday couldn't speak after his game. He was so overwhelmed with emotion that he was through to the final. In the last 50 years, four Swedish players have made the final. Household names in Sweden, Stellan Bengtsson, Kjell Johansson, Jorgen Persson, and Jan-Ove Waldner. And he joins that club now. It's an amazing performance by the, I was going to say the giant, the tall player from Sweden. Giant in status.
Absolutely. But in terms of the David Goliath factor, Goliath in black, Ma Long, again, the most decorated player, the standing Olympic gold medalist from 2016, the back-to-back and defending men's singles world champion from Suzhou 2015 to Dusseldorf 2017 in one of the most epic matches in table tennis history. Ma Long, about 2 months ago, there were questions, would he be recovered in time? Would he even be able to play? And here he is in the final, some of the most sharp form I've seen from Ma Long. He had that slight slip and scare. A look at who he's beaten, U.S.'s Kunik Jha, Vlady Samsonov, Hugo Calderano, the thrill from Brazil, Lin Gaoyuan, the dark knight, and Dapang Liang Jingquan. That is a very tough draw. Legends of the game, the future of the game, but let's talk about the 27-year-old Mattias Falk. Again, last year, he played very well, but in 2017, it showed round of 32. Look at how he got here, beating Robbie Gardosh, one of the great threats, or top threats to the Chinese, I'd say, over the years from Austria. Thiago Apollonia, top Korean Lee Sang-soo, and it continues on. But An Jae-hyun yesterday, really a tough match, quite a scare for Mattias Falk. Hungarian umpire Attila Petovari will be keeping an eye on the match to make sure that everything is fair and square. No advantage based on hiding serves, that the calls are made properly. Our assistant umpire, Stephen Gillespie, from Australia. The best umpires in the world, Don.
And absolutely, but I do think in general all the officials here have done a super job over the duration of this tournament. We've had very few incidents, if any incidents. We've had no major dramas. The players have been professional. The officials have been ultra professional as well. And everything has gone extremely smoothly. The crowd have enjoyed an outstanding World Championships. Jürgen Persson there in the corner, been there, done it. And that must be reassuring for Matthias Falk, that his coach is calm. And he mentioned yesterday, when he could get a few words out, that that influence was very important to him.
Yeah, you don't want to go skydiving tandem with someone who hasn't been through the routine before. And as you mentioned, Jürgen Persson knows success on the biggest stage against the Chinese. But here today, in terms of anticipation, there is no question who the favorite is. Ma Long has played Matthias Falk three times in the past and hasn't dropped a single game. 4-0, 3-0, and last year in Halmstad with the home crowd behind him, behind Matthias Falk, that is, it was 3-0 for the Dictator.
First game.
Someone asked me earlier, is there a chance for Matthias Falk? And my answer was, yes. Yes, there is. So let's see if he can pull out the best performance of his life here today. Best of seven, love all. Had the opening, earned a good opportunity, Don.
I think what's going to be interesting in the early part of this match is to see how Ma Long handles the short pimples on Falk's forehand. He serves on the forehand with the reverse, but during the rally, short pimples on his forehand, reverse rubber on his backhand. So basically, when he hits with his forehand, it comes through very flat. When he hits with his backhand, it comes through with topspin. And if you can adapt to that, and nobody has adapted really well to it, hence here he is in the final. But as you mentioned, Adam, 3-0 in Halmstad, 3-0 in Kuala Lumpur in the World Team Event Championships. The stats don't look good for Matthias, but let's keep our fingers crossed for the European player.
Right, regardless of what the odds are, we all hope for an exciting match here. And just imagining what it would be like, Matthias Falk would be able to pull this off. The energy in the world, I think global warming might burn. There it is, finds the middle, gets Ma Long jumping. Now it's interesting, we talk about the short pips on the forehand. That is the most unique part of Matthias Falk's game, that flat hitting shot with less rotation, tough to get into the rallies, but his backhand is the bread and butter that sets it up. It's the consistent shot with a lot of spin, something he can open with.
See there, Ma Long lifting the pimples. He just lifted a fraction too much. But it is awkward when the ball's coming flat, then it's coming with the topspin that you mentioned, Adam.
Yeah.
Back in history, now, you know, Stellan Bengtsson, the end of his career, played with short pimples, albeit on the backhand. Milan Orlowski, European champion, played with pimples on the backhand. But there's nobody at the moment hitting with short pimples, not many, and certainly not short pimples on the forehand.
Right, especially in the men's game, it's extremely uncommon. Now, in terms of advantages and disadvantages of being as tall as Matthias Falk is, crowd getting behind him here. He stands high, the table stays in the same place, so he's gonna have to have shorter strokes. He's got a bigger middle to attack. Advantages, he can cover the wide wings and he gets a lot of racket speed when he has time to open up. Ma Long's unpredictability factor is just the best. From over the table to his touch game, he hasn't allowed that opening attack. I think Matthias is going to have to take some risks over the table. He's going to have to play some uncomfortable balls and take some chances. As the underdog, if you play your average game, you pretty much guarantee success for your opponent. You just have to take some risks and hope that you make a high percentage. More positive play here, but Ma Long's serve, also quite deceptive, subtle, heavy spin here. What are you thinking, Don?
Well, I had the privilege to commentate with Stellan Bengtsson in 1999 at the World Championships in Eindhoven, and he'd just finished his career playing with short pimples, and he said, the one thing he said to me is, you've got to hit the ball at the top of the bounce and hit through with the pimples. But what Ma Long's doing here is topspinning very low over the net, so the ball's not bouncing up.
Right.
He's tactically, albeit it's early stages, his topspin, when he goes into the pimples, is perfect. Very low over the net.
Right, this is the perfect tactic. I think a lot of club players know what it's like to play a pen holder with short pips on the forehand who's in his 60s and get beaten. Served just a little loose. Ma Long has laser-like focus for detecting a ball that he can attack even while it's over the table. Oh, it's inside the line. I mean, study this man now. It's constantly a masterclass when he's playing. There's so much to learn from the brilliance of the dictator. Steady spin shot. Now, in terms of rhythm breaking, to make things uncomfortable, this is one thing that Matthias Falk is going to have to depend on, making things uncomfortable for Ma Long, which isn't easy. Koki Niwa was credited by Ma Long as making things uncomfortable. Ma Long said it's just always so uncomfortable to play Koki Niwa, despite having quite a dominant record against him. There we go, surprise flick. Tough to tell if it was the pancake flip, but it was quite surprising. I think we're going to see some of those from Ma Long throughout. It's only a two-point game right now. I mean, it felt like Ma Long was really running away, but this could quickly turn, Don.
Two great points there for Matthias Falk. Particularly the flick there, super shot with the pimples, top of the bounce, exactly as we were talking about, straight through it. Very flat, the ball.
Unbelievable. To the short side of the table, he doesn't leave too early, but when he leaves, he is gone, and there's no sign of his feet on the floor from before. Look how fast he turns. He even showed a push to begin with.
And he's that far across, he's off screen.
Uncanny, 30 years old. The speed of light puts him up by three on the receive.
Got it!
So calm. So with those short pips on the forehand, it's a flatter shot in general, but he can still spin the ball as you see here. A lot of players struggle to know how much topspin is on the ball because they really don't face this shot from this rubber. It's a very odd thing to encounter and difficult to find practice partners to prepare. 4 points in the lead, Ma Long on the serve. Comfortable covering the middle. Ma Long anticipates just a little, keeps the racket out in front, covers the elbow with the backhand side, and has 5 game points here in the first. Oh, the big counter. Trying to go a bit wide to the short side of the table. Not sure if that was an around-the-net attempt there. But Ma Long in control as he would be 11-5 takes game number one. It's a best of seven. Stick around. Game number two of the men's singles final coming up right after this. Players coming back to the table for game number two. The stands absolutely packed. We are here in Europe, but it's a good 50-50 between Ma Long supporters and the Matthias Falk fan club. Don, tough time right there between games.
Yeah, I was just putting myself in Jürgen Persson's shoes, and what would I say? I mean, it's really tough. You're up against the best player in the world, probably the best player over the last 50 years. That's a bit of a debate for later, but he's got to try and get the pimples in, the smash, take the ball at the top of the bounce, put him under pressure, be positive with the reverse side on his backhand, try and be unpredictable and go for a few 50-50 balls, take a chance, nothing to lose. But, yeah, no, Jürgen's got a tough job here.
Absolutely. I think helping his player believe, stay positive so that he plays every point, taking the chances, knowing he has the chance, and he's trying. Tries to go inside out with the flick there. Malong not allowing much room to breathe. Very little margin for error. Barely scraping over the net. Pips out there, yeah? Receive with the pips out on the forehand, trying to flick. Just missing still. Almost doesn't convert the point with that net ball and the shock received. That's how difficult it is and how much it takes to win a point against Ma Long, who you have to imagine is incredibly well prepared for this match. Don't see Ma Long chopping too often. Very specialized skill.
Unlucky. Unlucky. That was a good idea. Hit hard with the pips as soon as you can. You know, I was there in 1989 when Sweden played China in the final of the team event, and China had three players, and there was only one sheet of reverse rubber. Basically, Sweden were up against short pimples, Voldner, Persson, and Appelgren. And the coach, Glenn Hughes, told me that they practiced top spinning low over the net for a month on the pre-games camp. And here it's the other way around. It's how I suspect Marlong's been preparing for this. He's been preparing against somebody hitting with short pimples. He's been preparing topspinning low over the net. The roles reversed from 89 final. Sweden won 5-0, by the way, in that final. Took the Swedling Cup.
5-0, my goodness. I'm curious who Marlong actually practiced with. Just thinking about who's here in the hall right now and who you practice with. I know that many of the Japanese women have practice partners from China, for that matter, that can play with pretty much any setup you can imagine. I've seen players that use inverted, using long pips on top of the table, short pips to attack, switch to pen hold when they need. Just a 2-point lead, but at the first towel break, doubling the score of his opponent, Ma Long on the receive. This one gets away there, an attempted sort of tomahawk chop.
I don't know what he was trying there, a chop block. I think maybe he thought the ball was going long. It bounced right near the baseline, and he improvised.
Yeah, seemed a bit surprised, caught off guard behind the table to make the shot. There we go. The spinny one with the forehand on the short pips that's a little bit questionable, and the follow-up drive down the line takes a big risk here from behind the table. Again, you talked about catching the ball at its peak. That one just a little bit after the peak. Still, he made the shot. With the lack of rotation on the forehand, Matthias Falk, especially as a big guy, is going to have to focus on timing and taking the ball early as possible. Ma Long doesn't make that easy. He knows this coming in. As deep on the table as can be. You know, we hear the sound sometimes of the bounce, like it might have caught a little bit of the back edge, but it looks clean enough on the bounce. And that's another thing to shut down Ma Long. If it's inside the table at all, Ma Long's so fast and so well calibrated. So good on Matthias Falk for playing that one right.
And it was deep. It was right on the baseline. That's crucial as well.
Risky shot on the counter. Not an easy ball. And he plays it a little bit more centrally into the body of Ma Long. Watch the angle here from down low. Forces Ma Long to chicken wing it a little bit to throw that elbow up first to get out of the way. Now, Ma Long has shocked me with how impressively he can cover the middle with his forehand in this tournament, Don.
He's able to lean, almost contort his body to get in with, and still play with a lot of power. But Falk here just beginning to impose himself on this game.
I'll say 4 points in a row from down 2-5. He's in the lead. The nickname, I was wondering if I'd have a chance to call him the Swede in the lead in this match. Really, because Ma Long is playing incredible table tennis, but right now he is the Swede in the lead. Well, I said it, yeah. I said it quickly. We'll see. Still, based on the last 5 points, if he can keep up that sort of momentum, he would finish this game successfully. But as you mentioned, the odds are definitely, looking at history and the way Ma Long has been playing, not in Matthias Falk's favor.
but he's managed to get in with that forehand hit. As you say, he can spin the ball a little bit with the short pips once it's dropped, but getting to the ball, top of the bounce, hitting through Marlon's spin. Just got to keep trying for that. Well-placed topspin there by Marlon. It wasn't particularly powerful, but it was that crossover point where you're not sure whether to play a backhand or forehand. Just watch it. There it comes. He leans across and plays a backhand. Arguably, better going the other way, hitting the ball with the short pimples. Hindsight's a wonderful thing. I'd
Absolutely.
Be a gold medalist if hindsight was an Olympic event.
2024, actually. It's a discussion. This match will be watched for years and years. I hope that makes sense a decade from now. My comment, yours always do. But yeah, you know, as a taller player, we've seen it from Vlady Samsonov, covering the forehand side, using the backhand for a little bit more of the table. It is the more efficient stroke, the quicker stroke. But Malong knows that, so he plays it a little wider to the forehand than he would to find somebody else's elbow. That's 4 points in a row for Malong now.
Heavy backspin on the push.
I mean, he seems to have an answer for almost everything. That's the thing. If he can't drill it, he can spin it heavy. If he can't kill it or hit it out of reach, he can find a place that's extremely uncomfortable for you. And if you're ready to attack, he can shorten up the ball and break your rhythm. I guess that's why they call him the dictator. Taking advantage here of a slightly softer shot. Ma Long just bringing it back. This is what he did against Fang Zhendong in 2017 and even against Liang Jingquin yesterday. He said, go ahead, give me your best shot. Go, I'll give you the first one. You hit me, and let's just see what happens after that. But Matthias Falk taking advantage, the parallel. Electric atmosphere here in the arena. 2 points between them and the serves on Ma Long's side. Just missing. Incredible recovery off the net. Ma Long really was this close to being 9-8 up. Almost burned. Apologizes there for the fortune a few shots back. Still the touch game. No panic from Ma Long. Matthias played that as well as you can possibly play it, Don.
He gave himself a chance to win the point there and arguably unfortunate not to win it. Look how close that was there on the replay. Millimeters away from the white line.
And now we've got 3 game points for Ma Long. There it is, 11-7, a slightly closer game, but the dictator holds control, and we will be back for game number 3 of the men's singles final here at the World Championships right after this. Players coming back to the table for game number 3. The dictator up 2-0. Matthias Falk towels off the table for a clean and even bounce. The conversations just keep getting tougher. And according to Qin Zhijian, Ma Long's personal coach, no one has ever come back from down 0-3 against Ma Long. This is a crucial game here for a potential turning point in the match, Don.
I thought Falk did well there. 5-1 down, I think he was. He then got four or five points. Led halfway through it and played well, spinning the ball with the backhand, top of the bounce, hitting the ball with the short pimples.
There's Qin Zhijian in the corner, who had been out of the game for a little bit, but with Liu Goliang back in CTTA in a big way. Oh, man, that went on longer than I expected. I think the whole crowd was gasping that the Malone could bring these shots back on the table. I mean, we've got the Thanos snap from Malone, the Marvel fan, but we've got the hammer of Thor on the other side from Matthias Falk. Once he gets you behind the table, it's so tough to get back into the rally.
Every ball there by Falk played with purpose. No compromise, and that's exactly what he has to do.
Left two.
Go for his shots.
In case you were curious about what Ma Long was saying, flash photography in the crowd can be quite distracting.
Left three.
Again, I think the most distracting flash I've ever seen was against Waldner. I believe it is Swedish national championship. It deuce in the decider. So Matthias Falk using the backhand wisely gets a creative attempt out of Ma Long. One thing that's difficult to do is make Ma Long sweat, to put him under pressure, to get him nervous.
Heavy backspin on the Ma Long service there. Deceptive amount of wrist action going into that, cutting under the ball.
So first point for Ma Long here in this game. Now 3-1 for Matthias Falk. Good placement, long push comes out at the right time. Even still though, for Ma Long's standards, he just overlifted, he got there. He's incredibly agile, watch how quick his step is.
Yeah, not quite as much backspin on the ball from the short pips.
Oh, murderous forehand. Don, Matthias Falk is taking some chances here, but I feel like in the short game, he's earned himself the first attack almost consistently, 5-1 at the first towel break. The reverse pendulum there, tight. Gets a spinny ball from Ma Long, a little bit soft. He's taking the risks, playing the parallels, and it's paying off right now. It's gonna have to be something similar to this throughout the match, but Ma Long constantly changing tactics. He will adapt. It's what he does. Oh, surprise, Ma Long looks like he's going cross court and changes it up for the parallel. The level of focus right now from Matthias Falk, he's using the forehand whenever he can, spinning hard with the backhand.
Obviously there, Falk, we see him, he's away from the table, he's got to stay up to the table. He chanced his arm the previous point, ran round the backhand, smashed it down the line with the short pimples. Take a few more chances, Matthias.
What a setup here, wide off the table to the forehand and deep on top of the bounce, but it's like you said, Don, he stayed close to the table, was able to control the wide angles. For his height to stay this close, this is gonna have to be the sweet spot. This is gonna have to be where he builds his home. The real estate just behind the table.
Again, short pitch from the backhand side with his forehand. Not a lot of spin on that. Short pimples don't generate the same amount of spin. So here he goes, it hasn't quite got the top spin and the block into the net. There wasn't the spin on the ball that Ma Long thought there was.
He's playing so smart right now. This is what we see again from the underdog, short rallies. The longer the rally goes, the more it favors the stronger player. It's the law of averages. So as soon as the opportunity's there, Matthias Falk is not hesitating. Whether the pressure is spin, whether it's speed, all that combined with placement, Matthias Falk is trying to finish the rallies as quickly as he can.
And that was pretty quick.
Can't get much quicker than that on the receive. One shot wonder right there, in and out. That's what a forehand flick is all about.
Top of the bounce, bang, straight through the back of the ball.
Tighter serve here on the reverse pendulum. Ma Long shaking his head as if to say, how have I gotten to this score in game number three? Just the bottom part of the top of the net there. The Falkers in the crowd.
Falk, even I could interpret that one.
Not an easy ball to play. Ma Long very well calibrated here. Sits up just enough. But by the time he got to it, Ma Long played it just barely above net height. So really an impressive shot. had 9-2. Still quite close here to the finish line.
5-9.
Don, I've seen 9-2 comebacks before in this tournament alone. And if anyone here from the start of this tournament to the last match is capable of a comeback, it's the man in black. I think one more point, and we're going to see a timeout from Jorgen Persson, JP in the corner.
I was just thinking exactly the same thing. The momentum clearly back with Marlong.
He got the hesitation in the push game there, up in the front of the point. Matthias was able to get the first attack, take control, and finish. I feel like every shot is 100%. Again, whether it's spin or speed, he is so focused right now. 5 game points for the Swede in the lead. Oh, just missing. Outstanding rally, the rally of the match so far. Just incredible. The improvised shots. That forehand tomahawk chop comes back, and then he has to float it from under the table. The fishing game from Matthias Falk. When do you see this? He even had the counter with the forehand from way behind the table, but Ma Long kept control, kept his ground, didn't back off. He got the twiddle of the racket out of Ma Long, the red side to the forehand for the smashes. 4 game points left for Matthias Falk. Surprise flick, the placement. How can anyone know where that ball is going to go before it's hit?
And that went very deep into Falk's backhand.
I mean, it looked so clear that he had the cross-court shot. That's why he didn't go there. And he even faced the racket, as if to say, I'm giving you a hint. I'm going to your forehand. Oops, I'm not.
Went through very flat the way he angled his racket there. But that's it.
No timeout needed. 11-7. Matthias Falk, for the first time in his career, has taken a game off of Ma Long. Maybe the most important game of his life. Will it be the small spark that starts the fire that burns through? Game number 4 of the men's singles final coming up right after this. The fans snack in the crowd and cheer. It is the routine for Matthias Falk. The table cleaned, the sweat removed. And Matthias Falk versus Ma Long continue in game number 4. So one game here for Matthias Falk makes it quite interesting now, Don.
It certainly does. And he did everything we spoke about there. He took the initiative whenever he could. He tried to smash the ball when he could with the short pimples. He spun with the reverse rubber. He ran round the backhand to smash with the pimples with his forehand from the backhand side. Caution to the wind. Go for your shots.
This is probably the most support I've heard for Ma Long on the World Tour in my life. I think the fans know that they are needed right now. Good length. You can see the hesitation on Ma Long. He double pumps with the racket. Matthias Falk coming in for that quick receive off the bounce to keep it very short.
That's great touch from Falk there. Second bounce was going to be on the baseline. Slight hesitation from the world champ.
Now the placement here is tough. Matthias Falk knows Ma Long wants it to the corner. He just has to try and make a very quality shot if he's going to go here. Either go deeper to the backhand or try to play it a little on the forehand side. But it was a lukewarm shot inside the table, and that's a temperature that Ma Long loves to drink his tea at.
That's it. Perfect. soon as he got a chance, he's round, top of the bounce, the smash. Hopefully we'll see that again on a replay.
Now, the most important game of any match is always the last, but now that Matthias Falk has gotten one on the scoreboard, tying it up here, coming into the fifth with momentum and confidence. I mean, when Ma Long gets nervous, I think it's pretty much the only time I've ever seen him lose or even come close to losing is when he starts to look like he's stressed or sweating. How many times have we seen someone get one game off Ma Long and then he snaps his fingers, Thanos, it's over. Just one game, it's like you've woken up the beast.
But it's interesting, it's two short pushes from the Swedish player that have been decisive. His touch has been excellent.
For me, that was one of the most impressive things the first time I saw Matthias Falk when he was Matthias Carlsen back on the world tour. I'm like, wow, he's using short pips on the forehand. That must be tough in over the table in the touch game, but his receives, he could drop it so short. Yeah, incredible feeling. After all, he's the first player I've seen hitting around the net chop on the world tour. Opening ball, making it count. He's sticking to the plan here in the tactics. He's up 4-2 at the first towel break, Don.
And that was a great, the reverse rubber on the backhand this time. Top spin, a lot of spin on the ball, and exactly what he wants. Ma Long's not adjusting to the spin.
And the placement's perfect. He's got Ma Long leaning. While Ma Long can make that shot, it just weakens the power of his forehand when he has to lean. It takes the legs out of his shot. Some very strong, fast legs indeed. Non-stop right now. You know, he looked nervous to me in the beginning. Matthias Falk at the start of this match had some trouble in some of the rallies, just was missing shots that he's been making throughout. But right now, I said it once, I'll say it again, sometimes hitting rock bottom gives you a reality check, a sense of catharsis and just a freedom. It lifts a weight, and right now he's playing like he's got nothing to lose.
And look, here's the right idea. He was looking to spin it with his backhand. Funnily enough, I saw Jürgen Persson this morning. I know him a little bit from my time coaching, and I congratulated him, and he said one more to go. He felt that Falk had a chance, and he certainly does.
Now, I wasn't there to hear him say it, but there's a Shakespeare factor in that it could be interpreted a few different ways from a tired person, but I don't believe that's what Jürgen Persson meant.
I'm not sure Jürgen's into his Shakespeare.
You know, I actually had a chance to coach JP. Qatar Open a few years ago, I was in his corner.
I did the same. I coached Europe against Asia back in the 80s, and Jürgen Persson was in the team with Desmond Douglas from England and Mazanov from Russia. That was the team I looked after on a Euro-Asia. Got to know Jürgen very well.
Perfect placement again. Drilling that middle. He's found what he was missing for a few points. It was a bit of a comeback here. You know, I didn't realize that's something we had in common, Don. I don't think so many people can sit back in their chairs up here and say, hey, high five, we both coached world champion Jürgen Persson. I think in your case, you probably had a lot more sound advice than I did.
I'm not sure about that, but a privilege to coach him, and what a good guy.
Indeed, just celebrated his birthday here, actually. So Matthias Falk still up by one, serve on his side. Needs to find that quality first attack. Wow, I thought he was done when the serve drifted long, but he managed to regain control here, grab the reins in the point. That fishing shot with the backhand, Ma Long gave him one soft shot. I think Ma Long's got to know that at this point, if he gives Matthias Falk anything soft, it really has to be uncomfortable for him because he is looking to kill. Straight for the jugular on both sides. Matthias Falk is a man on a mission. The Swede in the lead by two.
5-7.
That's the expression. That is a player who's got some work to do, things to figure out, and is starting to realize the pressure. But one thing that Ma Long does, from here it could go two ways. He could get nervous, or he could do what he's done since 2015 and dictate. And he does, right at the baseline. I mean, this is a fast serve to get a push from Matthias Falk there that comes up and out that long, even if it comes down. I mean, it's almost a blind swing for the next shot after that receive. Very clever serve.
I think Falk was expecting the short serve, took him by surprise.
What a counter with the short pips. The ball comes in low, spinny, and deep. He's taking the risks, and that's what it's all about. He makes a high percentage of some very low percentage shots. Matthias Falk, man, the ticket holders here, everyone watching around the world right now, has two people to thank, and they're both on court. A lot more than that, of course. The teams that have made them the players that they are to be here, but it's a two-point lead for Matthias Falk.
Net 8-6.
Just wiping the sweat from the palm of the hand to make sure they have full grip on the racket handle.
If I'm Jürgen, I'm happy with that.
Yeah, he played it well. I think he was so satisfied, maybe, that he made some big shots here. He made a risky serve, risky backhand right down the middle. It almost looked like he was surprised that the ball came back as quick as it did. From this camera angle, I mean, he was ready. It just appeared that he wasn't in control of the point. Malone really took it over with that second shot.
That is higher and vertical.
Higher toss and vertical, the service warning.
It's got to go up with 6 inches.
Fair enough, you can understand why they'd want to keep the serve tight and keep the toss as low as possible. One thing that I love, Don, is that after the service warning, when a player could be flustered, and this is generally Matthias Falk, I mean, it's why he's Matthias Falk and not Matthias Carlson with Julia Carlson. It's because he's a very fair, kind person. And as soon as he heard the warning, he basically said, okay, he wasn't gonna let it bother him. He took the note and he stayed focused to get that first big backhand in. I'm going to pull a Don Parker here quote and say we're getting into the business end of the game.
Ooh.
He had to do it. He had a chance.
He had a chance. The tactics were good. He put himself into a situation to win the point. He's playing positive. He's spinning with the reverse side on the backhand. He's looking to hit with the pimples on the forehand. I mean, even though he's not winning points, if he's playing positive, he's in there with a chance.
Well, he's won more than Malone so far. He's still up by one, and I think you're right. I mean, really here, the timeout, I was wondering when we were going to see it. If not now, then when? And it has been called. To get Malone behind the table, you've already done one thing right. That's a start. But still, he's dangerous from anywhere on the court, as we've seen. Matthias Falk, though, with that hammer on the forehand side. Interestingly enough, why he uses short pips on the forehand is because his coach said to him, you know what, your arm moves too slow. You're just not getting the racket speed for a proper forehand. Let's put you with some rubber that matches your style. So he's got a shorter stroke on the forehand that works perfectly as a tall player for the short pips game. It's part of the reason we've seen it so much in the past for women on the backhand. It's such a fast game in the women's game, short strokes, all about speed near the table and the backhand to backhand rally. Although we're not seeing it quite as much. Mima Ito Mutsu a few years back was having some big wins. But between these two, the conversation in the corner, I think surprise placement, if it's a touch game, it's gotta be similar. As soon as you have the opportunity, recognize it, don't look back, just go.
I think Jürgen Persson will just be reinforcing the way he's been playing. He's just got to keep it going. Be positive, take the chances when they're there, don't hold back. You're not going to win points against Malone by just keeping the ball on the table.
And after all, he's won more points than Malone so far.
But what a pivotal moment this is now.
Right, if he doesn't capitalize and take this game, no timeouts left, he's down 1-3, we'll see. The serve came long, he had the opportunity, he missed the shot, but I don't think he can be feeling bad about making the wrong decision.
Absolutely, tactically it was the right thing to do. And you can see there, interesting, a good coaching point there, Jürgen Persson was clapping. He was clapping in the corner, and that's basically reinforcing to his player that you did the right thing, even though he lost the point.
Absolutely right. Matthias Falk now, the last two serve combination this game will have. Ooh, the whole table was open, just missed the back edge. Malong putting the pressure on, taking a risk himself here.
Again, on the replay, just look right. The push was a little bit mid-table. I thought it was a bit tighter than that. But Malong, wow, what a forehand topspin. Placed into the body of the tall Swedish player.
So now game point for the dictator on the receive, Matthias Falk. Looking to serve this one for deuce. Oh man, that is tough. I'm surprised. I mean, it looked like he might have had an opportunity for the backhand opening, but clearly he wanted that forehand. Malong getting the best there, good placement, and he goes up 3-1. No timeouts left for Matthias Falk. We'll see what happens. Game number 5 coming up right after this. Players back for game number 5. Malong leading 3-1, still has his timeout if he needs. Swedish fans in the crowd and all around the world cheering for Matthias Falk, trying to be the wind beneath his wings to will him back into this match. Had a good look at 9-7 in the last game, but under pressure, Malong successful. Wow. Fair enough. But he said, I couldn't hear you. Sorry, just wanted you to know it wasn't intentional. Yellow card there for stalling, not coming back to the table after the minute in the corner. And even though he said what he said, I had a sense that it struck a nerve a little bit, that right now it's like I'm dealing with enough. And it's a fair call, it's fine. But it's got to be frustrating to not turn around 9-7 and come back to a yellow card. So a full plate here for Matthias Falk.
But what an interesting reaction from Falk. He apologized. I'm really sorry.
Yes.
I didn't hear you. It wasn't a case of, come on, man. I'm in the final of the World
right.
Championship. Biggest game of my life.
Right.
I'm 10 seconds late, and you have a pop at me.
Right.
It was, I apologize. I'm really sorry.
Unbelievable, this man. As kind as they come.
And I really don't think at the end of that game, 9-8, Jürgen Persson called timeout. I think the timeout was a great call. I think the way he played when he came back to the table at 9-8 was the right tactics, just didn't quite work out. The dictator, well, he's not called the dictator for no reason at all. The best in the world, possibly over the last 50 years during my time in the game. And I think he showed why. They're really cool under pressure as well.
Again, we're looking at a man, 30 years old. Many have retired from table tennis at this age. From the Chinese national team. He is the defending world champion 2 times in a row, looking for a third here and 1 game away.
Long fast push, a lot of backspin. What I find fascinating, Adam, with the way the Chinese handle their players, you know, we've got Vladimir Samsonov playing at 43. We've got Timo Boll playing at 38. The Chinese tend to, the players' careers a little bit because they're constantly bringing players through.
Yes.
And they need to give the young players a chance. You don't see many great Chinese go on to play well into the 30s. It'll be very interesting what happens to Malong.
Well, again, his greatest enemy is Matthias Falk gets his second point here. His greatest enemy is injury. And he's been dealing with one recently. Again, about 6 months out of the game, off the World Tour, which is why we have a final between world rank number 11, Ma Long, and world rank number 16, Matthias Falk, who, as you mentioned to me earlier, best ranking, world number 12. Quite close to the top 10. Again, giving hope to the Swedes. Is Sweden back? The country that could challenge China and even dominate China for a period of time.
Still fighting, spinning the ball there with the backhand side, brushing up the back of the ball.
I want to talk mental strength briefly. Yesterday against An Jae-hyun, after losing 11-2 in game six, being down 2-4, I mean, it'd be easy for somebody to crumble. Matthias Falk went on a rampage. Oh, there's the counter. There it is from the wide forehand, using the wingspan to just smack it back. Short pips, Matthias Falk covers the middle there, gets low and leaning out in front. This is a very uncomfortable ball, but he succeeds. He excels and he thrives under pressure right now, Don.
He has the ability just to put everything behind him and focus on the next point. He doesn't appear to dwell on anything, even the yellow card he got at the beginning of this game. Forgotten, it's gone. Let's focus on what's in front. And I think that's one of the characteristics of being a mentally tough player.
Incredible focus. That'll probably be my last name pun for the match. 1 point in the lead, Ma Long on the receive. This is tough. There are a few times now that you and I both have had this quick pullback of air watching because he's earned himself a great opportunity and he's made tougher shots throughout the match, but it's still not an easy ball.
Exactly. The way he's been playing, you'd expect him actually to have put that one away. He didn't, but he's only human.
There are actually debates that that is not the case on Ma Long's side. Interesting.
Ma Long saying it was a side.
Yeah, for me it was.
As opposed to an edge.
For me it was.
And Ma Long's got the point.
Yeah, I mean, he was outside the table when he hit it. The ball went down as if it hit a wall.
Let's have a look.
Yes.
Awesome. I'm with you. What a great replay.
Man, that was probably the best replay I've ever seen to make something quite clear. Tough moment there for Pearson.
He's accepted it. He was a very fair player. I have to say, the picture throughout this whole tournament on court number one, 17 cameras, and it's just been awesome.
He's had his comeback earlier in this game. He was down from the start, but at the second towel break, Ma Long up 8-4. I mean, we mentioned before the match, the most common call to the bookies would probably have to be a 4-0 victory to Ma Long. And already, Matthias Falk has outdone that. He's come back in the past. He's shown determination and grit under pressure. To get this far has been absolutely mind-blowing global news for the Swede. But if he can win this match, all hell will break loose, Don.
I just think, as you say, he's come into this final with a track record of 4-0, 3-0, 3-0. He's playing the best player we've ever seen in the last 50 years or more. And I personally, and that's probably why I wasn't a very good player, I'd be worried about being humiliated. He has put up a great performance here. He's gone out there. He's played to win. He had a real chance when he could have leveled it at 2 games apiece, 9-8 up when the timeout was called in that fourth game. A credit to himself, his family. And that backhand down the line, a little bit of a lifeline, but 9-5 down against Ma Long. Can't see him coming back, but I've got everything crossed up here in the commentary box.
Yeah, we'd love to see this one go to game seven, and I know that a good percentage of the world, timeout called, Ma Long's side. Interesting. This is a fairly conservative timeout, but if anyone knows Ma Long well, maybe better than his parents in this situation, is right now his honorary father, his personal coach for a long time now, Qin Zhijian in the corner. It's got to be quite comforting in moments like this. I mean, really, we're starting to talk more and more. You know, there are some people, you know, Waldner is my favorite player in history. He is the Mozart of table tennis. He was the most creative. He was spectacular to watch. But just by numbers and records and domination, there's not much of an argument with Ma Long's statistics. If he wins this tournament here, which he's quite close to doing, if he takes this championship, I mean, there, people are going to have to find new conversations at bars after tournaments.
That's a great analogy. I said coming into this tournament, in my career in table tennis, not far short of 50 years, then the two players who stand out, Waldner and Ma Long. And I did say if Ma Long wins this, it's hard to argue that he's not the greatest. And here he is. He's 3-1 up. He is 9-5 up. He's just had a timeout. No doubt he's been told to focus. Let's do the job. Nice time to have a pause. Nice time to have a timeout up your sleeve.
So now all lifelines have been pulled. The parachutes have been used. It is free fall from here on out. And with the gloves tied tight, they enter the ring. Matthias Falk on the receive, the dictator ready to serve. Just missing the back edge again. Ma Long taking a giant risk here. He serves a handcuffing serve half long to the backhand, gets a lukewarm opening deep. I thought Matthias Falk's placement, if you can't play the short side of the table, was just right. And now it is 5 game, match, and championship points for the dictator. And Ma Long takes it 3 in a row, back to back to back, a turkey, a hat trick. This is the greatest of all time at this point in history. Ma Long putting it in stone. The world can know that you have been watching somebody nearly superhuman on the table, a masterclass for all. And respect to Matthias Falk, he came in with the gloves tied tight, gave quite a fight. Really a respectable performance, and in game 4, this could have opened up to go either way, but Ma Long right now, we've seen celebrations. He has got to be just out of his mind. Look at this man, Don.
Well, just watch this point again. There it is. And those arms go up, the emotions there. And it's not just, I think, because of what he's just done on the table. It's not that long ago when potentially he thought his career was over. His table tennis finished. And now he's been on a journey for some 7-8 months, and it accumulates in this point. And that's what it's all about there. That's what you can see on the screen. It's the last 6 months from being written off possibly to now being the greatest player ever.
And there it is. What a journey it has been. The dragon, the captain, the dictator holds down the regime. 3 times in a row, the most dominant player in the world.